Now, to discuss the D8 meetings and its implications for the nation's foreign policy, I'm now being joined on the news at 10 by the Senior Special Assistant to the President on Media and Publicity, Mr. Garba Shehu. Thanks a lot for joining us on the news at 10.
Thank you for having me.
Now, you've been part of the meetings all through the day, etc. What's your impression about Nigeria's outing at the summit?
Excellent. You know that President Muhammad Buhari, scored the two goals using one opportunity, because on arrival he proceeded straight to the capital, Ankara, where bilateral talks were held between Nigeria and the Turkey. And a lot of big issues in our relations with the Turkey, bilateral, multilateral, were discussed and resolved before we came to Istanbul for the G8 summit.
Well, I know you say that the outing was excellent, but do you think Nigeria has benefited from membership of the D8, as other countries have, looking at Egypt and some other participating nations? One major criticism that we have when we go into such agreements is that we don't often get out of it what we had expected. Is that the case for the D8 as well?
Well, if it had happened in the past, I think that the essence of what is happening in Istanbul, Ankara, at this moment, is that Nigeria is opening all the doors, all the windows that have been shut against international trade, and we are ready to open up. And the enthusiasm and interest of Turkey in particular, which is one of the leading economies in the group, is evident in their decision to join Nigeria in investing in petroleum refineries, in aviation, development of our airports, and the transformation of an institution like the Defense Industries Corporation, DIC, in Kaduna, into a military industrial complex. A lot of decisions have been reached in this regard.
All right, I know in his address, the president did talk about the first ever, I think, single market for trade in goods and services on the continent, and he says that that is also backed by the AU. Can you throw more light on it and how that's going to work and how it will benefit us?
Well, the decision to open Africa, eliminate visas and eliminate boundaries in the long run, is a decision of the African Union. And what the president did is to request for support for the D8, to see it as a one huge opportunity. Look, everyone keeps talking about the next century being Africa's century, and that he thinks that it's good for the D8 to make an early stage by engaging the continent this early on, so that they set in the most when this new policy comes into play.
All right, what specifically was agreed on defense and security? I know all through the last couple of days, we had talked about the fact that security, arms importation, et cetera. We don't actually have the finer details of what was agreed. Can you shed more light on that?
Exactly. I think the key agreement in this area includes the decision by both countries to support one another in fighting transnational crime. You just mentioned illicit arms importation. There's also human trafficking, there's also drug trafficking. Agreements have been reached on how to curtail this thing. The written agreement will be duly signed in the coming days and weeks when our lawyers have both studied the agreement. That is one aspect. The military agreement has also been reached for the training of Nigerian military men and women by Turkey. And as I said to you a short while ago, we have got at least two companies that are going to invest in the manufacture of V4A for consumption in Nigeria and export to other countries. Of course, we'll back each other fighting terrorism in the international stage and also in our individual countries, which are confronted by these challenges.
All right, we understand that Nigeria is planning to host the ministers of industry of the D8 sometime in November. What's that about?
Well, that's the big one for us, because all of these things that they are discussing, they want to expand trade between themselves. Not only do they want to increase their voice in international, they want to influence greater participation. As our report just said a short while ago, they target between 10 to 15% control of the world trade between themselves. They are going to put this to practice, and the Abuja meeting is expected to focus on the mechanism on how to achieve this objective.
Now, one of the reasons I'm asking this next question is because of what we hear the government plans to do in terms of withdrawing from some of these international bodies that we're members of. What is the criteria that we're looking at for the withdrawal and some of the reasons why? We know that debt is part of it, but is there any specific method to the withdrawal?
No, I don't think there is. Look, there are organizations that are there, you know, for the glory of being there. And there are some that have produced great results, such as this one. Government is going to be careful, there will be prudence in deciding which ones to cut. The thing, the problem this country had faced is the fact that people without the authorization to do so, directors in government ministries, when they attend international conference, they subscribe to memberships. This thing comes with financial implications. Without the Ministry of Finance being involved, without the President sanctioning such participation, we got ourselves involved in too many we cannot now pay for. So I assure you that there would not be a threat to organizations such as this that are beneficial to our economy as our own people.
And in terms of our specific foreign policy direction, that's one question I know you probably might not be the one to answer, but that is a question that does come up, particularly when we go on international outings like this, what our specific direction is for the continent and the world at large.
Well, certainly this is not my question. However, the president of Nigeria left the country with three clear objectives in his mind. He wants to get support and cooperation to tackle terrorism. He wants support cooperation to boost trade and enhance the private sector participation in our own economy. And I think that substantially, these three objectives have been met at this visit to Turkey.
All right, Senior Special Assistant to the President on Media and Publicity, Garba Shehu, thanks for joining us on the News at 10 tonight.
Thank you, I appreciate it.